as kids.
Hello, folks. It's me, the conductor. Today, we're going to meet an Ineosaurus. Actually, we'll meet his herd, a big group of his species. So come on along with me on the dinosaur train. All aboard!
Dinosaur train!
Once upon a time, there was a mom. Her name was Mrs. Pteranodon. Sitting on her nest, she heard a scratching and said,
"Oh boy, my eggs are hatching."
One by one, her kids popped free. Baby Pteranodons, 1, 2, 3.
I'll name you Tiny, Shiny, and Dawn.
But Tiny said,
"Wait, there's one more, Mom."
Last little baby was a different size, with teeth and a tail and big green eyes. He didn't look anything like the rest.
What am I doing in a Pteranodon nest?
But dear old Mrs. Pteranodon said,
"Oh, this is your family, and I'm your mom. You may be different, but we're all creatures. All dinosaurs have different features. Come on, buddy, we'll take a vacation. I'll get us a ticket at Pteranodon Station. We'll travel the world in sunshine and rain and meet all the species on the
dinosaur train.
Dinosaur train.
Dinosaur train.
Dinosaur train. Dinosaur train.
Gonna
ride.
The dinosaur train."
Cretaceous picnic grounds, here we come!
You two sure are excited.
I know, we're having a picnic. It's not every day we eat outdoors. Wait, actually we do.
But we don't always take the train to do it.
Tickets, tickets please. Well, hello, Pteranodon family.
Hello, Mr. Conductor.
It's just Tiny and Mom and me today. Dad and Shiny and Dolman on a fishing trip.
So we'll have a yummy fish dinner when we get back tonight.
If we have room in our tummies after our picnic.
You Pteranodons make me smile. Such a tight-knit family.
That's what a family is, Mr. Conductor. We stick together, live in our nest together, and eat a lot of fish together.
Well, did you know that there are all different kinds of dinosaur families? Some are quite large, and some don't even live in the same place all the time.
Even our family's different. We are 5 Pteranodons and 1 T-Rex. That makes us special.
Yeah.
That's true.
What? It is true. We're not going far today, Mr. Conductor. Just to the Cretaceous picnic grounds.
Popular destination. Everyone in the next car is heading there, too.
Sounds like they're having fun.
Let's go see what's so funny.
Whoa!
Look at them all.
And look at those pointy horns.
Hi, I'm Ernie Ineosaurus.
Hi, I'm Tiny, and this is Buddy.
You guys don't look like Ineosaurus.
We're not. We heard laughing and we had to find out what the joke was.
Looks like the joke is, how many Ineosaurs does it take to fill a car in the dinosaur train?
And the answer is, a whole train car full.
Oh, this is only part of my family. We're meeting the rest of the Cretaceous picnic grounds.
Hey, that's where we're going.
No kidding. Maybe we can picnic together.
There you two are. I wondered where you went off to.
Mom, this is Ernie. He invited us to picnic with his family.
Well, that's very nice, but we should check with Ernie's family.
It's fine. Love to have you.
Hooray!
Okay, then, thanks. Goodness, Ernie, you certainly have a large family.
Ma'am, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Ernie, grammar!
Sorry. I mean, you haven't seen anything yet.
What did Ernie mean by we haven't seen anything yet?
Well, what Ernie meant was... Actually, let me show you. The Ineosaurus have a different kind of family. Ineosaurus travel together, and they're proud of their distinctive nose horns.
Who wouldn't be? Those things are awesome. But what are they for?
I think I hear a hypothesis coming up.
Actually, hold that hypothesis, buddy, because first there's a tunnel coming up. Time tunnel! Time tunnel! Next stop, Ineosaurus Plane Station, in another part of the Cretaceous time period. Now, before you head off, buddy, I believe you had a hypothesis.
My hypothesis is that Ernie belongs to one really huge family.
Interesting. I bet you'll be able to test that hypothesis, because there it is, the Cretaceous picnic grounds.
Whoa, it's picnic heaven.
Ah, Mom, Tiny, look out!
Have a great time, Pteranodons! Ernie's family picnics are known to be big and pretty, active.
Okay, we're all off the train. Want to go meet the rest of us?
Wait, there's more of your family?
Come on! And this is where my family picnics. Actually, we call our group a herd.
Wow, Ernie, your herd is huge.
Super huge. You must have so many kids in your family.
Yeah, lots and lots of brothers and sisters.
Actually, I only have a mom and a dad, and 2 sisters. They're around here somewhere.
We have 2 other kids in our family, too. Shiny and Dawn.
So your family isn't any bigger than ours.
Yeah, I have a regular-sized family. My herd is huge! It's actually a bunch of small families that make up one big group. My herd travels around together, and we find food together, and protect each other.
So, a lot of small families make up a big herd. This is different, isn't it, Tiny?
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah!
Yeah!
Oh, yeah!
Yeah!
Whoa, Annie, two of your family members are fighting!
Someone's gotta stop them!
Nah, that's just Uncle Jack and Cousin Ralph. Watch what they do.
Yeah!
So, it's not a real fight?
Nope, just practicing.
Practicing? Practicing what? Scaring animals with their horns?
Well, when you live in a herd like we do protect each other from predators.
Oh, it certainly is impressive, Ernie.
Thanks, Mrs. Pteranodon. But mostly what the big grown-ups do, like my Uncle Jack, is help lead the herd.
Which one's Uncle Jack?
Want to meet him?
Yeah!
Uncle Jack!
Ernie! How's it going, nephew?
Good! Meet my friends. This is Pteranodon, Tiny, and Buddy.
Hello.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
That practice fight was amazing.
Yeah, you liked it, huh? Well, there's a lot of us Iniosaurus to lead. And we are just like one big happy family.
You mean one big happy herd.
Yeah, that's right. Our herd really sticks together.
And we have fun.
That's what I'm talking about. So, you know any games?
Oh, that's what Ralphie and I were doing.
Playing a game called King of the Herd.
Like the game we play at home. King of the Hill.
I even play sometimes. Right, Unc?
Oh, right. Can we play?
Now, Tiny, don't get carried away. You don't have horns.
Ernie doesn't have a big horn.
Not yet, I don't. But I will.
You bet you will. Someday he'll grow a nasal horn just like mine.
A nasal horn?
Yep, this horn on my nose. But they're just for show, to impress the other dinosaurs. So there's no reason Ernie or even Tiny and Buddy can't play.
Yeah!
Woo-hoo! Okay, kids. Now you play King of the Herd by circling each other.
Sort of like a dance.
That's right. And then this is the key. Act tough.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Like this?
Bingo! The idea is to look tough and scary. To intimidate the other guy. Then you run past each other like you mean business.
Like we're King of the Herd.
Right. Okay. Ready, set, intimidate!
Watch out! Here I come!
I'm ready!
Ah, nice job. I'm so glad you're interested in our Iniosaurus ways.
Buddy and Tiny are always curious.
Say, you haven't had a shot yet, Mrs. Pteranodon.
Me? Oh, I couldn't.
Hey, we're always looking to groom new leaders for the herd.
It's a real important job.
Come on, Mom.
Queen of the Herd.
Well, I guess I could try it once.
Yeah!
Come on!
Come on!
Yeah! Whoa, that's one mean face.
Glad we don't see that very often.
Good job! Way to go, Mrs. Pteranodon!
You are so intimidating, Mom!
Aw. So this is what it's like to feel like part of the herd.
Feel warm and safe. Hey, do you want to play more?
Sure, but maybe after we eat. Playing King of the Herd made me really hungry.
Yeah, me too. So,
let's eat!
Mm-mm-mm. What a meal.
That was one yummy picnic.
So, you guys got to learn about herds today. But I still don't know what it's like to live in a single family group like you.
It's great, too. In its own way.
We sleep and eat in our nest on a cliff in Pteranodon Terrace.
And we're almost always together.
And we all love to fish.
Yeah, and we travel a lot. We can go anywhere at the drop of an egg.
We always ride the dinosaur train and only take up two seats.
It does sound really fun and so different from us Iniosaurus.
But that's great. We're all different.
You're right, buddy.
We're all creatures with different features. There's our train.
Time to go, kids.
Thanks for having us, Ernie.
And for teaching us about herds.
You're welcome. Thanks for visiting.
Uncle Jack, thanks for letting us play King of the Herd. It was a blast.
And it was great to meet y'all. Come visit the herd anytime.
We will.
Bye.
So long, Pteranodon family.
Well, we definitely heard that.
Mom did such a great job being intimidating. The herd loved it.
And Ernie's uncle showed us how to play King of the Herd. He could really use that nasal horn of his.
That's a nose horn. And one day, Ernie will have horns just like his uncle's. And then, watch out!
I don't know if I like living in a herd. Talk about sharing the spotlight. I think I prefer my family, where I can really shine.
It was fun to be with a big herd, but I'm glad to be back with our little family again.
Let's play King of the Herd.
But we're not really a herd, buddy.
We're a Pteranodon T-Rex herd. Dad, want to be king of our herd?
I think that's asleep. Oh, Dad.
Hi there. I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is Ineosaurus.
Ineosaurus.
Now, what's the first thing you notice about Ineosaurus?
Its horns.
Yeah, Ineosaurus is a horned dinosaur, or ceratopsian, just like Triceratops. Let's compare them. Triceratops had a small horn over the nose and huge horns over the eyes. But Ineosaurus had a large curved horn over the nose, plus two big spikes at the back of its frill. Scientists think that Ineosaurus may have lived in large groups called herds. Herds are a great way for herbivores to defend themselves against predators. More animals in a herd means more eyes to watch out for carnivores. Can you think of a large plant-eating animal alive today that lives in herds?
A wildebeest.
That's a great one. Wildebeest and Ineosaurus have a lot in common. Both are big, both have horns, and both tend to travel in large herds. Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Dinosaurs were big.
Tiny, look at all these dinosaurs.
Whoa, they're huge.
Someday I'm going to be one of the biggest carnivores on land. Roar! I'm a Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Hi, Mrs. Giganotosaurus.
I wonder who really is the biggest dinosaur.
Good question.
Big he is. Huge.
Whoa, that's one big dinosaur.
It's me, the conductor. Today, we're going to the big pond to meet a Hesperornis. Can it fly? Can it run? Can it swim? We'll find out. So come on along with me on the dinosaur train. All aboard!
Okay, now we're playing a game called I'm a Dinosaur and I Live In. Then you tell us where you live. I'll go first. I'm a dinosaur and I live in a tree.
I live in a hole.
I live in a nest.
I'm a dinosaur and I live in...
the water.
Wait, in the water? Is there any kind of dinosaur that lives in the water?
Yeah, I thought only fish and crabs and turtles live in the water.
And those creatures definitely are not dinosaurs.
I'm not sure if any dinosaurs live in the water.
Mom, do you know?
Well, I know that many, many creatures live in the water. Some small, some big, and some really big. But dinosaurs in the water?
Hey, we could do an investigation at the big pond.
Good idea, buddy.
Can we, Mom? Please?
I don't see why not. Plus, I want to find out if dinosaurs live in the water.
Hooray! We're going to the big pond.
And on the way, we can ask the conductor our big question.
To the dinosaur train!
Tickets! Tickets, please!
Mr. Conductor, we have a big question. This is a good time to ask.
Well, this is a perfect time. I feel smarter than usual. Let's hear it.
Okay. Is there any kind of dinosaur that lives in the water?
Behold, the Hesperornis. This dinosaur is quite an interesting specimen because, yes, it does live in the water.
Wow! I knew it! Woohoo!
The Hesperornis looks kind of like a bird. It has small wings.
And a beak. And weird feet.
And you're sure it's a dinosaur?
Yep, as sure as I have feathers and a toe claw. And you could possibly meet this exceptional Hesperornis at the Big Pond. Next stop, Big Pond! Good luck, Pteranodon family!
Thanks! Bye!
So if this Hesperornis guy lives in the water, we have to look for him in the water. Shiny, Don, you two fly over there and over there. Buddy, you're a good lookout. Why don't you climb up high and see if you can spot him?
And what are you going to do?
I'll look right here.
I don't see any Hesperornis. I'm hungry. Mom, can I go catch a fish?
Sure, Dawn. I'll be right here.
Mom, look at the water.
Ah! Ah! What's going on? Is it a bunch of fish swimming by?
Or one huge fish coming up?
Maybe we should get out of here.
scaring you there, buddy.
I'm not Buddy. I'm Don.
Oh, well, hi, Don. My name's Jess. Jess Asperornis. If I knew you were going to be here, I would have brought you a fish. You eat fish?
Hi, Jess. I'm Tiny Pteranodon. This is Shiny and Buddy and my mom.
Hello, 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 and hello. I've seen you Pteranodons flying around the pond.
Yeah, we do that a lot. Jess, I'm just double checking. You really are a dinosaur who lives in the water?
I am, Tiny.
Yes, a dinosaur that lives in the water.
Actually, I'm a dinosaur and a bird. Pretty neat, huh?
A dinosaur and a bird?
Yep. Asperornis live in the water, but hold your beaks and tails. I also come out of the water sometimes and hang out on the beach.
I never knew there was a dinosaur like you, and now we're actually meeting you.
And I'm meeting you. Hey, friend.
Hey, friend. So you live in the water and walk on land and swim. You can do it all.
We'll see, Dawn.
Huh?
One thing I know I can do is... Hello. Something underwater needs my attention. I'll be back before you can say this two times. The Happy Hyper Hesperornis is forever finding fish. Go!
Take it, Buddy. Say it twice.
The Happy Hyper Hesperornis is forever finding fish. The Happy Hyper Hesperornis is forever finding
fish. Did someone say fish?
That was so fast. How did you do it?
I bet Jess can do anything.
Well, it's just one of those things that water dinosaurs can do. Having these feet helps.
Wow, you have really big feet
and long toes.
Yeah, they're lobed feet. These babies really help me go fast. Take a look. They turn out, then I move them fast through the water and zip. My whole body moves fast with them.
All my feet can do is this. Hesperornis feet are so cool. I bet you can swim faster than any creature, Jess.
Well, I'm not sure if I'm the fastest.
I bet you are. And I think you can swim farther down in the water than anyone else.
I do like diving way down.
Just like I love flying way up.
Whoa, that is high up, Tiny.
Not too high, Tiny.
Oh, Mom.
Can we see how far down you can dive, Jess?
Well, I don't want to say I can go down really, really far, but hey, I can go down really, really far. There, I said it.
All right, you'll dive down for us?
Sure, why not?
Come on, everybody. Let's watch Jess dive and use his big, long feet.
I always do. Don't forget my flat tail. I use it to change direction. To the left, to the right, I move it back and forth.
It's just another Hesperornis thing I do.
Okay, ready to watch me dive?
Yes!
Good. I'll be back in a flash.
I can still see him. A little. Barely. I can't see him anymore.
Wow. He's been underwater for so long.
Like a fish. But Jess is a dinosaur and a bird. Jess! Hello? Come back up.
I hope Jess is okay.
Don't worry, Shiny. I'm sure Jess is fine. He did say that diving is what Hesperornis do.
I guess he'll come up when he needs to.
Hey, how's it going, gang? What did I miss? Anyone for some fresh fish?
You were underwater for so long.
We were worried. You were worried, Shiny. I wasn't. I know you were just doing what Hesperornis do.
You got that right, Dawn. But thanks for worrying about me, Shiny.
So, Jess, how far down did you go?
I'm not sure. Far enough to see lots of creatures. Big, small, some with shells, some with teeth, some with tentacles.
I really wish I could dive way down like you, Jess. Hey, can I try?
Dawn, we don't want you to get hurt. Pteranodons don't dive down deep in the water.
We just go in, grab a fish, and pop back out.
Your mom and Tiny are right, Dawn. We both dive in the water, but in different ways. But we both want to catch the same thing, fish.
Yeah, I guess so, Jess.
But you know, I can't fish the way you do, flying up and diving down.
What? Of course you can. You can do it all. You swim really fast, dive down underwater, catch fish, fly, walk on land, and probably run fast, and maybe even climb up trees.
That's really nice of you, Dawn. But hey, you know, I have to catch a lot of fish for my family. My mom, dad, and brothers have huge appetites. Anyone want to help?
Yes!
And I'll be your spotter.
Great! Let's fish!
Hey, there's some fish over there!
Woo-hoo!
Oh, good job, everyone! You're a fun, fantastic, fresh fish-fetching family of totally terrific, tremendous pteranodons!
Yeah! Yeah! Hey, Jess, maybe you can try to fish like a pteranodon. You know, fly up and dive down together?
We all can. It'll be fun.
Sorry to tell you, but with these little wings, there isn't much flying I can do.
Really?
Really. Watch.
Oh, okay, I think it's time for me to get back in the drink.
That means water.
And that, folks, is how a Hesperornis flies. Oh, well, I have funny little wings and a big old neck and great feet and a beautiful beak. Life is good.
I like my beak, too.
Me, too.
Me, too.
Nice teeth, buddy. Like mine. Check out these chompers.
Whoa.
Hey, you want to use those beaks and eat some of this fish we caught?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Race you guys to the fish.
I'm not much for racing when I'm on land. That's why I like to hang out in the drink. These lobed feet are great in the water, but they don't really help me run.
Jess, you know who can really run fast? Buddy. Buddy, show Jess.
I don't think Jess really wants to see me run.
Oh, sure I do. Show us, buddy.
Yeah. Whoa, buddy.
Awesome, buddy. Just awesome.
Hey, can we fish more? Let's go back in the drink.
Aw, oops. I bet that's your ride home.
Aw. Wanted to fish more.
We will another time, Dawn. Jess, it was great to meet you.
Can we be friends now forever?
Oh, absolutely, Dawn. Bye, you guys. We'll see each other soon. Gotta die.
Bye, Jess.
Good fishing with you.
See you soon.
We're a fun, fantastic, fresh fish FM family of totally terrific, tremendous, Herodotine.
Okay, try saying Hesperornis three times fast.
Hesperornis, Hesperornis, Hesperornis.
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Hesperornis.
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 Hesperornis was a bird that lived during the Mesozoic era, the time of the dinosaurs. And since all birds are actually dinosaurs, Hesperornis was both a bird and a dinosaur. Now, check out the wings on this bird.
They're tiny wings.
Even though Hesperornis was a bird, it couldn't fly. Instead, it lived in the water and used its big feet to swim very fast. Can you think of a bird living today that can't fly and lives in the water?
Penguins.
Right. Penguins can't fly, but they're great swimmers. And penguins do have pretty big wings that they use for swimming. And there's one thing that penguins and Hesperornis all have in common. They all like to eat...
fish!
Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Did you know that the dinosaur train travels everywhere in the Mesozoic era? Let's look at the map. There was the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous time periods. Let's visit the Cretaceous. Many new kinds of flowers and insects appear during this time. The most dinosaurs, like Tyrannosaurus rex, and flying creatures, like pteranodons, lived in the Cretaceous. And that's just one of the stops on the dinosaur train.
Time for a tiny ditty. And that means fish. If I could wish for just one dish, my greatest wish would be more fish.
Folks, it's me, the conductor. Today, we're going to meet an Ineosaurus. Actually, we'll meet his herd, a big group of his species. So come on along with me on the dinosaur train. All aboard!
Dinosaur train!
Once upon a time, there was a mom. Her name was Mrs. Pteranodon. Sitting on her nest, she heard a scratching and said,
oh boy, my eggs are hatching!
One by one, her kids pop free. Baby Pteranodons, 1, 2, 3!
I'll name you Tiny, Shiny, and Dawn.
But Tiny said,
wait, there's one more, Mom!
Last little baby was a different size, with teeth and a tail and big green eyes. He didn't look anything like the rest.
What am I doing in a Pteranodon nest?
But dear old Mrs. Pteranodon said,
oh, this is your family and I'm your mom. You may be different, but we're all creatures. All dinosaurs have different features. Come on, buddy, we'll take a vacation. I'll get us a ticket at Pteranodon Station. We'll travel the world in sunshine and rain and meet all the species on the...
Dinosaur train!
Dinosaur train!
Dinosaur train!
Dinosaur train! Dinosaur train.
We're gonna ride!
Ride!
The dinosaur train!
You two sure are excited.
I know. We're having a picnic. It's not every day we eat outdoors. Wait, Actually, we do.
But we don't always take the train to do it.
Tickets! Tickets, please! Well, hello, Pteranodon family!
Hello, Mr. Conductor!
It's just Tiny and Mom and me today. Dad and Shiny and Dolman on a fishing trip.
So we'll have a yummy fish dinner when we get back tonight.
If we have room in our tummies after our picnic.
You Pteranodons make me smile. Such a tight-knit family.
That's what a family is, Mr. Conductor. We stick together, live in our nest together, and eat a lot of fish together.
Well, did you know that there are all different kinds of dinosaur families? Some are quite large, and some don't even live in the same place all the time.
Even our family's different. We are 5 Pteranodons and 1 T-Rex. That makes us special.
Yeah.
That's true.
What?
It is true. We're not going far today, Mr. Conductor. Just to the Cretaceous picnic grounds.
Popular destination. Everyone in the next car is heading there, too.
Sounds like they're having fun.
Let's go see what's so funny.
Whoa!
Look at them all.
And look at those pointy horns.
Hi, I'm Ernianiosaurus.
Hi, I'm Tiny, and this is Buddy.
You guys don't look like Dinosaurus.
We're not. We heard laughing, and we had to find out what the joke was.
Looks like the joke is, how many dinosaurs does it take to fill a car in the dinosaur train?
And the answer is, a whole train car full.
Oh, this is only part of my family. We're meeting the rest of the Cretaceous picnic grounds.
Hey, that's where we're going.
No kidding. Hey, maybe we can picnic together.
Oh, there you two are. I wondered where you went off to.
Mom, this is Ernie. He invited us to picnic with his family.
Well, that's very nice, but we should check with Ernie's family.
It's fine. Love to have you.
Hooray!
Okay, then, thanks. Goodness, Ernie, you certainly have a large family.
Ma'am, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Ernie, grammar!
Sorry. I mean, you haven't seen anything yet.
What did Ernie mean by we haven't seen anything yet?
Well, what Ernie meant was... actually, let me show you. The Dinosaurus have a different kind of family. Dinosaurus travel together, and they're proud of their distinctive nose horns.
Who wouldn't be? Those things are awesome. But what are they for?
I think I hear a hypothesis coming up.
Actually, hold that hypothesis, buddy, because first there's a tunnel coming up. Time tunnel! Time tunnel! Next stop, Dinosaurus Plane Station, in another part of the Cretaceous time period. Now, before you head off, buddy, I believe you had a hypothesis.
My hypothesis is that Ernie belongs to one really huge family.
Interesting. I bet you'll be able to test that hypothesis, because there it is, the Cretaceous picnic grounds.
Whoa, it's picnic heaven.
Ah, oh, Ernie, look out!
Have a great time, Pteranodons! Ernie's family picnics are known to be big and pretty, active.
Okay, we're all off the train. Want to go meet the rest of us?
Wait, there's more of your family?
Come on! And this is where my family picnics. Actually, we call our group a herd.
Wow, Ernie, your herd is huge!
Super huge! You must have so many kids in your family.
Yeah, lots and lots of brothers and sisters.
Actually, I only have a mom and a dad, and 2 sisters. They're around here somewhere.
We have 2 other kids in our family, too. Shiny and Dawn.
So your family isn't any bigger than ours.
Yeah, I have a regular-sized family. But my herd is huge. It's actually a bunch of small families that make up one big group. My herd travels around together, and we find food together, and protect each other.
So, a lot of small families make up a big herd. This is different, isn't it, Tiny?
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah! Yeah! Oh, yeah!
Yeah!
Whoa, Ernie, 2 of your family members are fighting!
Gotta stop them!
Nah, that's just Uncle Jack and Cousin Ralph. Watch what they do.
Yes!
So, it's not a real fight?
Nope, just practicing.
Practicing? Practicing what? Scaring animals with their horns?
Well, when you live in a herd like we do protect each other from predators.
Oh, it certainly is impressive, Ernie.
Thanks, Mrs. Pteranodon. But mostly what the big grown-ups do, like my Uncle Jack, is help lead the herd.
Which one's Uncle Jack?
Want to meet him?
Yeah!
Uncle Jack!
Ernie! How's it going, nephew?
Good! Meet my friends. This is Pteranodon, Tiny, and Buddy.
Hello. Hi.
Nice to meet you.
That practice fight was amazing.
Yeah, you liked it, huh? Well, there's a lot of us Dinosaurus to lead. And we are just like one big happy family.
You mean one big happy herd?
Yeah, that's right. Our herd really sticks together.
And we have fun.
That's what I'm talking about. So, you know any games?
Oh, that's what Ralphie and I were doing.
Playing a game called King of the Herd.
Like the game we play at home. King of the Hill.
I even play sometimes. Right, Unc?
Oh, right. Can we play?
Now, Tiny, don't get carried away. You don't have horns.
Ernie doesn't have a big horn.
Not yet, I don't. But I will.
You bet you will. Someday he'll grow a nasal horn just like mine.
A nasal horn?
Yep, this horn on my nose. But they're just for show, to impress the other dinosaurs. So there's no reason Ernie or even Tiny and Buddy can't play.
Yeah!
Woo-hoo! Okay, kids. Now you play King of the Herd by circling each other.
Sort of like a dance.
That's right. And then this is the key. Act tough.
Oh, like this?
Bingo! The idea is to look tough and scary, to intimidate the other guy. Then you run past each other like you mean business.
Like we're King of the Herd.
Right. Okay. Ready, set, intimidate!
Watch out! Here I come! I'm ready!
Ah, nice job. I'm so glad you're interested in our Iniosaurus ways.
Buddy and Tiny are always curious.
Say, you haven't had a shot yet, Mrs. Pteranodon.
Me? Oh, I couldn't.
Hey, we're always looking to groom new leaders for the herd.
It's a real important job.
Come on, Mom.
Queen of the Herd.
Well, I guess I could try it once.
Yeah!
Come on!
Mrs. Pteranodon,
you can do it!
Whoa, that's one mean face.
Glad we don't see that very often.
Good job! Way to go, Mrs. Pteranodon!
You are so intimidating, Mom!
Aw.
So this is what it's like to feel like part of the herd. Feels warm and safe. Hey, do you want to play more?
Sure, but maybe after we eat. Playing King of the Herd made me really hungry.
Yeah, me too.
So,
let's eat!
Mm-mm-mm. What a meal.
That was one yummy picnic.
So, you guys got to learn about herds today. But I still don't know what it's like to live in a single family group like you.
It's great, too.
In its own way.
We sleep and eat in our nest on a cliff in Pteranodon Terrace.
And we're almost always together.
And we all love to fish.
Yeah. And we travel a lot. We can go anywhere at the drop of an egg.
We always ride the dinosaur train and only take up two seats.
It does sound really fun and so different from us Iniosaurus.
But that's great. We're all different.
You're right, buddy.
We're all creatures with different features. Aw, there's our train.
Time to go, kids.
Thanks for having us, Ernie.
And for teaching us about herds.
You're welcome. Thanks for visiting.
Uncle Jack, thanks for letting us play King of the Herd. It was a blast.
And it was great to meet you all. Come visit the herd anytime.
We will.
Bye.
So long, Pteranodon family!
Well, we definitely heard that. Did such a great job being intimidating. The herd loved it.
And Ernie's uncle showed us how to play King of the Herd. He could really use that nasal horn of his.
That's a nose horn. And one day, Ernie will have horns just like his uncle's. And then, watch out!
I don't know if I like living in a herd. Talk about sharing the spotlight. I think I prefer my family, where I can really shine.
It was fun to be with a big herd. But I'm glad to be back with our little family again.
Rawr! Let's play King of the Herd.
But we're not really a herd, buddy.
We're a Pteranodon T-Rex herd. Dad, want to be king of our herd?
I think Dad's asleep.
Oh,
Dad.
Hi there. I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is Iniosaurus.
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 Now, what's the first thing you notice about Iniosaurus?
Its horns.
Yeah, Iniosaurus is a horned dinosaur, or ceratopsian, just like Triceratops. Let's compare them. Triceratops had a small horn over the nose and huge horns over the eyes, but Iniosaurus had a large curved horn over the nose, plus two big spikes at the back of its frill. Scientists think that Iniosaurus may have lived in large groups called herds. Herds are a great way for herbivores to defend themselves against predators. More animals in a herd means more eyes to watch out for carnivores. Can you think of a large plant-eating animal alive today that lives in herds?
A wildebeest.
That's a great one. Wildebeest and Iniosaurus have a lot in common. Both are big, both have horns, and both tend to travel in large herds. Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Dinosaurs were big.
Tiny, look at all these dinosaurs.
Oh, they're huge!
Someday I'm going to be one of the biggest carnivores on land. Roar! I'm a Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Hi, Mrs. Giganotosaurus.
I wonder who really is the biggest dinosaur.
Good question.
Big he is. Huge!
Oh, that's one big dinosaur.
It's me, the conductor. Today, we're going to the big pond to meet a Hesperornis. Can it fly? Can it run? Can it swim? We'll find out. So come on along with me on the dinosaur train. All aboard!
Okay, now we're playing a game called I'm the Dinosaur and I Live In. Then you tell us where you live. I'll go first. I'm a dinosaur and I live in a tree.
I live in a hole.
I live in a nest.
I'm a dinosaur and I live in...
the water.
Wait, in the water? Is there any kind of dinosaur that lives in the water?
Yeah, I thought only fish and crabs and turtles live in the water.
And those creatures definitely are not dinosaurs.
I'm not sure if any dinosaurs live in the water.
Mom, do you know?
Well, I know that many, many creatures live in the water. Some small, some big, and some really big. But dinosaurs in the water?
Hey, we could do an investigation at the big pond.
Good idea, buddy.
Can we, Mom? Please?
I don't see why not. Plus, I want to find out if dinosaurs live in the water.
Hooray! We're going to the big pond.
And on the way, we can ask the conductor our big question.
To the dinosaur train!
Tickets, please!
Mr. Conductor, we have a big question. This is a good time to ask.
Well, this is a perfect time. I feel smarter than usual. Let's hear it.
Okay. Is there any kind of dinosaur that lives in the water?
Behold, the Hesperornis. This dinosaur is quite an interesting specimen because, yes, it does live in the water.
Wow! I knew it! Woohoo!
The Hesperornis looks kind of like a bird. It has small wings.
And a beak. And weird feet.
And you're sure it's a dinosaur?
Yep, as sure as I have feathers and a toe claw. And you could possibly meet this exceptional Hesperornis at the Big Pond. Next stop, Big Pond! Good luck, Pteranodon family!
Thanks! Bye!
So if this Hesperornis guy lives in the water, we have to look for him in the water. Shiny, Don, you two fly over there and over there. Buddy, you're a good lookout. Why don't you climb up high and see if you can spot him?
And what are you going to do?
I'll look right here.
I don't see any Hesperornis. I'm hungry. Mom, can I go catch a fish?
Sure, Dawn. I'll be right here.
Mom, look at the water.
What's going on? Is there a bunch of fish swimming by?
Or one huge fish coming up?
Maybe we should get out of here.
Sorry for scaring you there, buddy.
I'm not buddy. I'm Don.
Hi, Don. My name's Jess. Jess Hesperornis. If I knew you were going to be here, I would have brought you a fish. You eat fish?
Hi, Jess. I'm Tiny Pteranodon. This is Shiny and Buddy.
Hi.
And my mom.
Hello, 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 and hello. I've seen you Pteranodons flying around the pond.
Yeah, we do that a lot. Jess, I'm just double checking. You really are a dinosaur who lives in the water?
I am, Tiny.
Yes, a dinosaur that lives in the water.
Actually, I'm a dinosaur and a bird. Pretty neat, huh?
A dinosaur and a bird?
Yep. Hesperornis live in the water, but hold your beaks and tails. I also come out of the water sometimes and hang out on the beach.
I never knew there was a dinosaur like you, and now we're actually meeting you.
And I'm meeting you. Hey, friend.
Hey, friend. So you live in the water and walk on land and swim. You can do it all.
We'll see, Dawn.
Huh?
One thing I know I can do is...
Hello. Something underwater needs my attention. I'll be back before you can say this two times. The Happy Hyper Hesperornis is forever finding fish. Go!
Take it, buddy. Say it twice.
The Happy Hyper Hesperornis is forever finding fish. The Happy Hyper Hesperornis is forever finding
fish. Someone say fish.
That was so fast. How did you do it?
I bet Jess can do anything.
Well, it's just one of those things that water dinosaurs can do. Having these feet helps.
Wow, you have really big feet.
And long toes.
Yeah, they're lobed feet. These babies really help me go fast. Take a look. They turn out, then I move them fast through the water and zip. My whole body moves fast with them.
All my feet can do is this. Hesperornis feet are so cool. I bet you can swim faster than any creature, Jess.
Well, I'm not sure if I'm the fastest.
I bet you are. And I think you can swim farther down in the water than anyone else.
Hmm. I do like diving way down.
Just like I love flying way up.
Whoa! That is high up, Tiny.
Not too high, Tiny.
Oh, Mom.
Can we see how far down you can dive, Jess?
Well, I don't want to say I can go down really, really far, but hey, I can go down really, really far. There, I said it.
All right, you'll dive down for us?
Sure, why not?
Come on, everybody. Let's watch Jess dive and use his big, long feet.
I always do. Don't forget my flat tail. I use it to change direction. To the left, to the right, I move it back and forth.
It's just another Hesperornis thing I do.
Okay, ready to watch me dive?
Yes!
Good. I'll be back in a flash.
I can still see him. A little. Barely. I can't see him anymore.
Wow. He's been underwater for so long.
Like a fish. But Jess is a dinosaur and a bird. Jess! Hello? Come back up.
I hope Jess is okay.
Don't worry, Shiny. I'm sure Jess is fine. He did say that diving is what Hesperornis do.
I guess he'll come up when he needs to.
Hey, how's it going, gang? What did I miss? Anyone for some fresh fish?
You were underwater for so long.
We were worried. You were worried, Shiny. I wasn't. I know you were just doing what Hesperornis do.
You got that right, Dawn. But thanks for worrying about me, Shiny.
So, Jess, how far down did you go?
I'm not sure. Far enough to see lots of creatures. Big, small, some with shells, some with teeth, some with tentacles.
I really wish I could dive way down like you, Jess. Hey, can I try?
Dawn, we don't want you to get hurt. Pteranodons don't dive down deep in the water.
We just go in, grab a fish, and pop back out.
Your mom and Tiny are right, Dawn. We both dive in the water, but in different ways. But we both want to catch the same thing, fish.
Yeah, I guess so, Jess.
But you know, I can't fish the way you do, flying up and diving down.
What? Of course you can. You can do it all. You swim really fast, dive down underwater, catch fish, fly, walk on land, and probably run fast, and maybe even climb up trees.
That's really nice of you, Dawn. But hey, you know, I have to catch a lot of fish for my family. My mom, dad, and brothers have huge appetites. Anyone want to help?
Yes!
And I'll be your spotter.
Great! Let's fish!
Hey, there's some fish over there!
Woo-hoo!
Good job, everyone! You're a fun, fantastic, fresh fish-fetching family of totally terrific, tremendous pteranodons!
Yeah! Hey, Jess, maybe you can try to fish like a pteranodon. You know, fly up and dive down together?
We all can. It'll be fun.
Sorry to tell you, but with these little wings, there isn't much flying I can do.
Really?
Really. Watch!
Oh, okay, I think it's time for me to get back in the drink.
That means water.
And that, folks, is how a Hesperornis flies. Oh, well, I have funny little wings and a big old neck and great feet and a beautiful beak. Life is good.
I like my beak, too.
Me, too.
Me, too.
Nice teeth, buddy. Like mine. Check out these chompers.
Whoa.
Hey, you want to use those beaks and eat some of this fish we caught?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Race you guys to the fish.
I'm not much for racing when I'm on land. That's why I like to hang out in the drink. These lobed feet are great in the water, but they don't really help me run.
Jess, you know who can really run fast? Buddy. Buddy, show Jess.
I don't think Jess really wants to see me run.
Oh, sure I do. Show us, buddy.
Yeah. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Buddy.
Awesome, buddy. Just awesome.
Hey, can we fish more? Let's go back in the drink.
Aw, oops. I bet that's your ride home.
Aw. I really wanted to fish more.
We will another time, Dawn.
Jess, it was great to meet you.
Can we be friends now forever?
Oh, absolutely, Dawn. Bye, you guys. We'll see each other soon. Gotta die.
Bye, Jess.
Good fishing with you.
See you soon.
We're a fun, fantastic, fresh fish, Jess and Natalie, a totally terrific, tremendous Pteranodon.
Okay, try saying Hesperornis 3 times fast.
Hesperornis, Hesperornis, Hesperornis.
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Hesperornis.
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 Hesperornis was a bird that lived during the Mesozoic era, the time of the dinosaurs. And since all birds are actually dinosaurs, Hesperornis was both a bird and a dinosaur. Now, check out the wings on this bird.
They're tiny wings.
Even though Hesperornis was a bird, it couldn't fly. Instead, it lived in the water and used its big feet to swim very fast. Can you think of a bird living today that can't fly and lives in the water?
Penguins.
Right. Penguins can't fly, but they're great swimmers. And penguins do have pretty big wings that they use for swimming. And there's one thing that penguins and Hesperornis all have in common. They all like to eat...
fish!
Keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Did you know that the dinosaur train travels everywhere in the Mesozoic era? Let's look at the map. There was the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous time periods. Let's visit the Cretaceous. Many new kinds of flowers and insects appeared during this time. The most dinosaurs, like Tyrannosaurus rex, and flying creatures, like pteranodons, lived in the Cretaceous. And that's just one of the stops on the dinosaur train.
Time for a tiny ditty. And that means fish. If I could wish for just one dish, my greatest wish would be more fish.
PBS Kids.
Hello, folks. It's me, the conductor. Today, we're going to visit some Lesothosaurus, a dinosaur that's really good at hiding. So come on along with me on the dinosaur train. All aboard!
Dinosaur train!
Once upon a time, there was a mom. Her name was Mrs. Pteranodon. Sitting on her nest, she heard a scratching and said,
"Oh boy, my eggs are hatching!"
One by one, her kids caught free. Baby Pteranodons, 1, 2, 3.
I'll name you Tiny, Shiny, and Dawn.
But Tiny said,
"Wait, there's one more, Mom."
Last little baby was a different size, with teeth and a tail and big green eyes. He didn't look anything like the rest.
What am I doing in a Pteranodon nest?
But dear old Mrs. Pteranodon said,
"Oh, this is your family, and I'm your mom. You may be different, but we're all creatures. All dinosaurs have different features. Come on, buddy, we'll take a vacation. I'll get us a ticket at Pteranodon Station. We'll travel the world in sunshine and rain and meet all the species on the
dinosaur train.
Dinosaur train.
Dinosaur train.
Dinosaur train.
The ride.
Ride, 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 ride.
The dinosaur train."
Once ago, Shiny, where are you? Gotcha! I found you all!
But you didn't find me!
Dad!
Dad's pretty big, so he should be easy to find.
Nope, not here.
Not here either. Dad!
Ta-da! Here I am!
Wow, what a great hiding place! How did you do that?
Well, I just covered myself with leaves and made like I was a bush. And I didn't move at all.
It's like you were part of the bushes and leaves.
I wonder if anyone could ever hide better than Dad.
Dad is the best hider of everybody everywhere.
Even better than me. I love hiding.
Not me. I like to be the finder. I just really like finding and meeting dinosaurs more than hiding.
You know, there's a special word for when a creature can use their body's colors to blend into the environment around them. It's called camouflage.
Camouflage? How do they do that? I mean, how do they blend in? I wonder what it must feel like.
You know, buddy, I just don't have all the answers, but I know somebody who might.
The conductor.
Can we go in the dinosaur train and ask him about camouflage, please?
Okay. I'll take these two camouflage investigators to the train.
While Shiny, Dawn, and I have a great day at the beach.
Yeah!
Yeah! Camouflage!
Hello, Pteranodons. and T-Rex.
Hello, Mr. Conductor.
Ready for a train ride?
Just a sec.
All aboard.
Hi there, Mr. Engineer. Okay, I'm ready. Hey, guys.
Hello, Dino.
Tickets, please.
Mr. Conductor, we were playing hide and seek this morning. You should have seen how good Dad was at hiding.
He used camouflage. That's a big new word Mom taught us. I bet you know all about it.
Your mom is absolutely right.
Thanks.
And yes, I do know about camouflage. All of these animals use their body color to blend into their surroundings. It helps them survive by hiding from predators.
You know, creatures who want to eat them.
And that is camouflage.
Camouflage. Blending in with the stuff behind you, so predators won't be able to find you.
That was amazing, Tiny.
Good job.
Look, buddy, all those creatures are hiding just like Dad did back at the nest. Except they're doing it even better. We can't see them at all.
A butterfly, a lizard, and a bird. But none of them are dinosaurs. Mr. Conductor, are there any dinosaurs who use camouflage?
But of course. They're just usually not big dinosaurs. It'd be pretty hard to hide Laura Giganotosaurus or Ned Brachiosaurus, because, well, they're really big. But this little dinosaur, called Lesotosaurus, is one of the best ever at using camouflage.
So, Lesotosaurus are light brown with dark brown stripes.
And they can hide really well?
That's what I've heard.
Maybe someday we can see a Lesotosaurus.
Or try to see one, because they can hide so well.
Well, you're in luck, because I know there's a Lesotosaurus family who lives at the next stop.
Mom?
A dinosaur family who we've never met and who are really good at hiding.
Using camouflage.
How can I say no? I can't. Let's go on an expedition.
It's that time. Time tunnel. Time tunnel approaching.
Ooh.
The Lesotosaurus Landing Training Station in the Jurassic time period.
Bye.
Good luck finding that camouflaged Lesotosaurus family. This expedition, you're really going to need it.
Bye.
I don't see anyone. Do you?
I don't. But they're camouflaged, so we should look for them really carefully.
Well, I'm a great finder, remember? I'll find them. Hello? Anybody there?
Nobody here either. Tiny, maybe you can fly up there and look in the branches.
Great idea, buddy. No camouflaged dinosaurs up here either.
Everything around here is pretty brown, so if the Lesotosaurus are brown too, we'll never find them.
This is the hardest game of hide and seek ever.
Oh, it's hot too. Let's cool off in the shade for a minute.
Maybe the Lesotosaurus are so good at using camouflage that we've already searched where they're hiding.
You might be right, buddy.
Yeah, I guess we might never see them. The Lesotosaurus probably want to hide from predators.
I don't just hide from predators.
Did you say that?
No, I thought you said it.
Well, then who said that?
Don't look at me.
Hello? Is someone hiding right here, right next to us?
Excuse me, hello. I'm Mrs. Lesotosaurus.
Hi, I'm Tiny Pteranodon. This is Buddy and my mom. It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too, Tiny. Hi, Buddy and Mrs. Pteranodon.
Hello.
Hi.
I wonder, have any of you seen my daughter, Leslie?
We haven't met your daughter, but I think we might have just heard her.
That sounds like my Leslie. She's pretty shy around strangers and likes to hide.
Here I am. Is that you, Leslie?
Whoa, that's amazing. I can hear you, but I can't see you. Really good camouflage, Leslie.
Leslie, you're such a fast runner.
Hey, Tiny.
What?
You're talking to a bush.
Not a bush. I'm trying to talk to a dinosaur named Leslie, who I'd really like to meet.
Yeah, Leslie. Come out and play with us. We won't hurt you.
We're really super friendly.
You sound really friendly. It would be nice to make some new friends.
So come on out so we can see you.
Well, sometimes I think it's easier to hide and watch other creatures make friends instead of making them myself.
But, Leslie, there's nothing more fun than making friends.
You know, Leslie, I get nervous sometimes when I meet new dinosaurs. I think that maybe they won't like me. But you don't have to worry about that, because we already know that we like you.
Hi.
Hi! Sorry, I'm Tiny Pteranodon. It's great to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, Tiny. Hi. I've never seen creatures who look like you guys and who are so friendly.
Well, there's no one friendlier than Tiny.
Tiny will talk to any creature, and it doesn't matter if they're really huge or really tiny. Leslie's just the opposite. Lesotosaurus only usually hide from predators, but Leslie likes to hide from everyone.
Well, Leslie, you're the most amazing hider we've ever seen.
I just like to hide a lot. That's who I am.
watch. My skin color is so much like the color of the rocks that you can't even see me, because I don't move at all. Cool, let me try.
Buddy, are you there? I can't see anything around this big orange rock.
Okay. How about this for camouflage?
Wow, is that the bush or Buddy I'm looking at?
I guess it's a T-Rex bush.
Good one, Leslie.
Yeah, I guess I'm not very good at using camouflage. Nothing like you, Leslie. But I'm good at being a T-Rex.
Rawr! Run and hide!
I wish you didn't have to leave. I'm having so much fun, and I'm not even hiding. Well, now I am. Found you two! Come on out!
Hiding is fun, but it's fun to meet new creatures, too. And there are so many to meet.
How do you do it, Tiny? How is it so easy for you to talk to other creatures and not be afraid?
I can't really say, but I can sure sing it.
I'm not the biggest dinosaur. In fact, I'm kind of tiny. I don't have teeth or scary claws, but it doesn't make me whiny. Whenever I meet someone new, I march right up, and what I do is say, hello there, nice to meet you.
My name is Tiny.
I've met a lot of dinosaurs, and some of them were scary. And when I stand right next to them, I'm kind of ordinary. But if I'm friendly, they are too. And when I say it's nice to meet you, then they say, well, hey, the same to you.
It's nice to meet you, Tiny.
Hello there, Pteranodon family. Hope you had a nice trip. Meet any Lesotosaurus?
We did.
A really nice one named Leslie.
She's... Hey, where'd you go?
Leslie, where are you?
Hi, I'm Leslie. And it's nice to meet you, Mr. Conductor.
The pleasure is all mine, Miss Lesotosaurus.
Wow, Leslie, you did it. You walked up and introduced yourself to someone new.
I couldn't have done it if I hadn't met you and Buddy. You really helped me. Thanks.
You're welcome. Great to meet you.
All aboard!
Buddy, Tiny, time to head home. Bye, Lesotosaurus family.
Bye! Come visit her next sometime. We'll play hide and seek.
And I bet you'll be harder to find than our dad.
Bye!
Hi there. I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is Lesotosaurus.
I don't see a dinosaur.
Well, this dinosaur is using camouflage.
What's camouflage?
Well, animals camouflage when it blends in with its surroundings to hide from other creatures. There, now can you see the dinosaur? We don't know for sure if Lesotosaurus had camouflage coloring, but some dinosaurs must have. Lots of animals living today use camouflage, either to hide from predators or to hide when they're hunting. Now, can you find the polar bear in this picture?
It's right here.
There's the polar bear.
Right. Now, can you find the butterfly in this picture?
I see it. There's the butterfly.
That's it. Okay, last one. Can you find the frog in this picture? It blends in really well.
I see it. It's a frog.
Good eyes. This is an Asian leapfrog. Pretty amazing camouflage, huh? Hey, where'd you guys go? Now the kids are using camouflage. Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Dinosaurs have feathers. Croodonts have feathers?
It's like me.
Whoa, they're amazing.
Well, thanks, buddy.
I'm a northern Troodon. We're different because we got a lot more feathers, eh?
We're looking for a match for this feather.
Looks familiar.
I wish I had your amazing feathers. Can we compare this one to yours?
Wow,
the feather mystery is solved.
Woohoo, yeah.
All aboard, all aboard. Let's take a ride on the dinosaur train. Here she comes, right on time. The dinosaur train's coming down the line.
All aboard, all aboard.
Rattle and bang, rumble and roar. She's hopping and a-pumping like a hurricane.
Hello, folks. It's me, the conductor. Today, we'll take a look at a Cretaceous plant that's a carnivore. That's right, a plant that eats bugs. So come on along with me on the dinosaur train. All aboard!
Yeah! Okay, now we're playing Be a Plant, Then Stay Still. So, be a plant.
Or a tree.
I'm a tree.
Me too.
I'm a big plant with wavy arms. Okay, now stay still.
I'm a wavy plant, and I like to eat animals and bugs and pteranodons.
Ton, there's no such thing as a plant that eats those things.
There is now. Come on, come back and be still.
Okay, you make up the rhymes.
And we'll divide the kids into teams.
What are Mom and Dad laughing about?
I don't know. Let's find out.
Oh, what a...
Mom? Dad? What are you doing?
What?
We're making a plan.
That's right. For today.
Ooh, something for all of us to do?
Absolutely. It's something fun for our whole family.
Yay! But what is it?
All right, Team Pteranodon, here's the plan. First, we take the dinosaur train to...
Ankylosaurus Acres?
Stegosaurus Forest?
Troodon Town?
We're going to the Big Pond. Yay! And there's the dinosaur train. Let's go, team.
I really want to know what the fun plan is.
Please tell us. Pretty please with little fishies on top.
Are we going fishing? Or tracking?
Or hiding and seeking?
Well, we were going to wait till we got there, but here goes. We're doing a family scavenger hunt.
What?
A scavenger hunt is when you get clues to help you find things.
A scavenger hunt!
Hi, two, buddy.
Hi, three.
Yeah!
Oh, there's the train. Let's hurry.
Yeah. A scavenger hunt? Oh, you Pteranodon family. Forever having fantastic family fun.
Yeah, maybe we'll have to hunt for a really big fish.
Or a conifer tree.
Or a frog.
Or a plant with wavy arms that eats animals and bugs and dinosaurs.
Oh, Dawn, this is a real scavenger hunt.
We're not going to hunt for a plant that's not even real.
Actually, Shiny, there is a real plant like that.
There is? I knew it. Tell us about it, Mr. the Conductor.
Indeed I will. This is the Drosera plant. It's actually a plant that's a carnivore.
A carnivore? Like me?
That's right. The Drosera eats the bugs that land on it. They end up down its tube.
Why?
Well, all living things eat. Carnivores eat meat, herbivores eat plants, and plants need water and sunlight. But some plants, like the Drosera, need more. They need bugs.
Woohoo! So we might find Drosera plants at the big pond?
Yep. Maybe you'll see one on this trip. Or maybe another time. Oh, speaking of time, we're here. Big pond! Next stop, big pond! Good luck, Pteranodon family. And happy hunting. Scavenger hunting, that is.
Okay, Team Pteranodon, let's huddle by the puddle. Listen close. I know you can, because here's the super scavenger hunt plan. Hunt?
Rock!
There are four things all of you are going to hunt for.
Four different things?
Right. But there'll be clues that rhyme.
Cool.
I love rhymes.
Oh, and one more thing. Your mom and I think it'd be fun to divide into teams.
Goody. I love teams. It'll make the scavenger hunt even more fun.
So, each team will get the same clue and search for the same item.
Okay, I'll decide the teams.
Thanks, Shiny. But Dad and I have already decided the teams. Team 1 is Tiny Dawn and me. Team 2 is Shiny Buddy and Dad.
Yay!
Rah!
Good teams, Mom.
All right, ready for your first clue? That's the rhyme about the item you'll be looking for. You solve it together as a team. Take it away, hun.
Listen carefully, kids. We found him by digging in the ground. His parts were scattered all around. A skeleton from his toes to his head. This fellow's name is...
Good luck, Buddy and Shiny and Dad.
Thanks. Good luck to you guys.
We found him by digging. A skeleton. Toes to his head.
Is it something in Dawn's collection?
A skeleton from his toes to his...
Mom, Tiny, it's Fossil Fred.
You're right, Dawn. Hurry, let's fly there.
Fossil Fred!
Good clue, Mom and Dad.
It's amazing that this was once a living dinosaur.
Yeah, these fossils are really old bones that turn into raw.
That's our Fossil Fred. Okay, what's the next clue, Mom?
I have it. Listen carefully. A shell on his back is one of his features, and he borrowed it from some other creature. He's a friendly guy, and he likes to gab. This fellow is a...
A shell on his back. A turtle?
But he borrowed his shell.
I bet it's a shell on the beach. Come on!
Let's get to the beach. Hurry!
He's a friendly guy, and he likes to gab. This fellow is a...
Hermit crab!
Henry, his home is a shell. Good one, Shiny.
Thanks. Start looking under every shell, Buddy and Dad.
Henry!
Wait, I think I see some little feet sticking out of that one. Henry, it's me, Shiny.
Shiny? Hey, my old pals, Shiny and Buddy, and Mr. Pteranodon. What's new?
We're on a scavenger hunt, and one of the clues was about you.
Hey, I like being a clue. Glad I could be of service.
Henry, I observed that you have the same shell you had the last time we saw you.
Right. I haven't grown out of my shell yet, but pretty soon I'll have to vamoose and find another empty shell to move into.
That's what hermit crabs do.
Okay, Mom and Dad, what's the next clue for the scavenger hunt?
I wish I was bigger, then I could play the game too.
Oh, wait, I have an idea.
The clue. This likes to eat all kinds of bugs. I repeat, to it, bugs are a treat. It might eat a beetle. It might eat an ant. It grows in the ground. It's a... Maybe I can come along and, you know, help with the clues.
I'll carry you, Henry. Come on.
This likes to eat all kinds of bugs. I like it already, whatever it is.
It might be a beetle. It might be an ant.
Hey! Lamp rhymes with ant. Mom, Dad, I bet it's the Drosera plant that the conductor told us about.
Yeah, let's look where all the flowers are.
Oh, bug-eating plant, la-la-loo, where are you?
If it eats bugs, does the plant have a tummy?
Remember the picture the conductor showed us? Kind of had a tube for a tummy.
Hey, lots of bugs flying that-a-way.
Yes!
The Drosera plant, just like the conductor's picture.
Bug just landed on it. Whoa. Bug went down its tube.
Well, that's where the Drosera plant eats the bug. You see, it has sweet nectar on its inside, and that makes bugs want to land on it. Then the plant slowly eats it.
Wow, this is my new favorite plant.
Ew.
Disgusting.
Okay, next clue, please.
Great job, Team Pteranodon. You found three items on the scavenger hunt. And now, the fourth and final clue.
This dinosaur has teeth, a tail, and three toed feet. He's really friendly, really sweet. A creature everyone likes to meet.
Lots of teeth.
And three toed feet.
Really sweet. It's a creature everyone likes to meet. Who do we like to meet?
It sounds like some kind of theropod. I wonder if it's a carnivore.
Lots of teeth.
A creature everyone likes to meet.
I got a pretty good idea who it is.
It's Buddy!
Me?
You're right! It's Buddy!
My teammate is the answer! It's my brother, Buddy!
Buddy, we were both close!
That scavenger hunt was the best!
But who won?
Won? Well, we all won! Great job, team!
Thanks, Mom and Dad! That was fun!
We had so much fun, too! Get all that scavenger hunting made you all hungry. How about some lunch? Fish for everybody.
Yeah, but not hermit crabs, right?
A scavenger hunt, some rhymes and lunch with a family that I love a bunch. We got four clues and figured them out.
And that's what a scavenger hunt's about. Scavenger hunt! Scavenger hunt!
Scavenger hunt!
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is the Drosera plant, also called a sundew. Now, most plants get all their energy from sunlight, but a few, like this one, actually get some of their energy from eating insects.
Plants that eat insects?
Yup, the insects go to the plant hoping to find food, but instead they get stuck on the hairs and are eaten by the plants. There were Drosera plants during the time of the dinosaurs, and today they're found on every continent except Antarctica. And they come in lots of different sizes, shapes, and colors.
Hungry plants?
The most famous insect-eating plant is called the Venus flytrap.
Venus flytrap!
It's just a small plant, but when an insect lands on one of its leaves, it closes, trapping the bug.
Mmm, tasty bugs.
Okay, remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries.
Did you know that the dinosaur train travels everywhere in the Mesozoic era? Let's look at the map. There was the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous time periods. Let's visit the Jurassic. It was a warm, damp climate full of both jungles and forests. first known birds and many of the biggest dinosaurs, like Stegosaurus, lived in the Jurassic. And that's just one of the stops on the dinosaur train.
Time for a tiny ditty.
And we figured it out.
We figured it out. We worked together and figured it out.
PBS Kids.
Hello, folks. It's me, the conductor. Today, we're going to visit some Lesothosaurus, a dinosaur that's really good at hiding. So come on along with me on the dinosaur train. All aboard!
Dinosaur train!
Once upon a time, there was a mom. Her name was Mrs. Pteranodon. Sitting on her nest, she heard a scratching and said,
"Oh boy, my eggs are hatching!"
One by one, her kids popped free. Baby Pteranodon, 1, 2, 3.
I'll name you Tiny, Shiny, and Don.
But Tiny said,
"Wait, there's one more, Mom."
Last little baby was a different size, with teeth and a tail and big green eyes. He didn't look anything like the rest.
What am I doing in a Pteranodon nest?
But dear old Mrs. Pteranodon said,
"Oh, this is your family, and I'm your mom. You may be different, but we're all creatures. All dinosaurs have different features. Come on, buddy, we'll take a vacation. I'll get us a ticket at Pteranodon Station. We'll travel the world in sunshine and rain and meet all the species on the
dinosaur train.
Dinosaur train.
Dinosaur train.
Dinosaur train.
The ride.
The dinosaur train."
Once ago, Shiny, where are you? Gotcha! I found you all!
But you didn't find me!
Dad!
Dad's pretty big, so he should be easy to find. Nope, not here.
Not here either. Dad!
Ta-da! Here I am!
Wow, what a great hiding place! How did you do that?
Well, I just covered myself with leaves and made like I was a bush. And I didn't move at all.
It's like you were part of the bushes and leaves.
I wonder if anyone could ever hide better than Dad.
Dad is the best hider of everybody everywhere.
Even better than me.
I love hiding. Not me. I like to be the finder. I just really like finding and meeting dinosaurs more than hiding.
You know, there's a special word for when a creature can use their body's colors to blend into the environment around them. It's called camouflage.
Camouflage? How do they do that? I mean, how do they blend in? I wonder what it must feel like.
You know, buddy, I just don't have all the answers, but I know somebody who might.
The conductor.
Can we go in the dinosaur train and ask him about camouflage, please?
Okay. I'll take these two camouflage investigators to the train.
While Shiny, Don, and I have a great day at the beach.
Yeah!
Yeah! Camouflage!
Hello, Pteranodons and T-Rex.
Hello, Mr. Conductor.
Ready for a train ride?
Just a sec.
All aboard!
Hi there, Mr. Engineer. Okay, I'm ready. Hey, guys.
Hello, Dino.
Tickets, please!
Mr. Conductor, we were playing hide-and-seek this morning. You should have seen how good Dad was at hiding.
He used camouflage. That's a big new word Mom taught us. I bet you know all about it.
Your mom is absolutely right.
Thanks.
And yes, I do know about camouflage. All of these animals use their body color to blend into their surroundings. It helps them survive by hiding from predators.
You know, creatures who want to eat them.
And that is camouflage.
Camouflage. Blending in with the stuff behind you, so predators won't be able to find you.
That was amazing,
Johnny. Good job. Look, buddy, all those creatures are hiding, just like Dad did back at the nest. Except they're doing it even better. We can't see them at all.
A butterfly, a lizard, and a bird. But none of them are dinosaurs. Mr. Conductor, are there any dinosaurs who use camouflage?
But of course. They're just usually not big dinosaurs. It'd be pretty hard to hide Laura Giganotosaurus or Ned Brachiosaurus, because, well,
they're really big.
But this little dinosaur, called Lesotosaurus, is one of the best ever at using camouflage.
So, Lesotosaurus are light brown with dark brown stripes.
And they can hide really well?
That's what I've heard.
Maybe someday we can see a Lesotosaurus.
Or try to see one, because they can hide so well.
Well, you're in luck, because I know there's a Lesotosaurus family who lives at the next stop.
Mom?
A dinosaur family who we've never met and who are really good at hiding.
Using camouflage.
How can I say no? I can't. Let's go on an expedition.
It's that time. Time tunnel. Time tunnel approaching.
Ooh.
Next stop, Lesotosaurus Landing Train Station in the Jurassic time period. Good luck finding that camouflaged Lesotosaurus family. This expedition, you're really going to need it.
I don't see anyone. Do you?
I don't, but they're camouflaged, so we should look for them really carefully.
Well, I'm a great finder, remember? I'll find them. Hello? Anybody there?
Nobody here either. Tiny, maybe you can fly up there and look in the branches.
Great idea, buddy. No camouflage dinosaurs up here either.
Everything around here is pretty brown. So if the Lesotosaurus are brown too, we'll never find them.
This is the hardest game of hide and seek ever.
Oh, it's hot too. Let's cool off in the shade for a minute.
Maybe the Lesotosaurus are so good at using camouflage that we've already searched where they're hiding.
You might be right, buddy.
Yeah, I guess we might never see them. The Lesotosaurus probably want to hide from predators.
I don't just hide from predators.
Did you say that?
No, I thought you said it.
Well, then who said that?
Don't look at me.
Hello? Is someone hiding right here, right next to us?
Excuse me, hello. And this is Lesotosaurus.
Hi, I'm Tiny Pteranodon. This is Buddy and my mom. It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too, Tiny. Hi, Buddy and Mrs. Pteranodon.
Hello.
Hi.
I wonder, have any of you seen my daughter, Leslie?
We haven't met your daughter, but I think we might have just heard her.
That sounds like my Leslie. She's pretty shy around strangers and likes to hide.
Here I am.
Is that you, Leslie?
Whoa, that's amazing. I can hear you, but I can't see you. Really good camouflage, Leslie.
Leslie, you're such a fast runner.
Hey, Tiny.
What?
You're talking to a bush.
Not a bush. I'm trying to talk to a dinosaur named Leslie, who I'd really like to meet.
Yeah, Leslie. Come out and play with us. We won't hurt you.
We're really super friendly.
You sound really friendly. It would be nice to make some new friends.
So come on out so we can see you.
Well, sometimes I think it's easier to hide and watch other creatures make friends instead of making them myself.
But Leslie, there's nothing more fun than making friends.
You know, Leslie, I get nervous sometimes when I meet new dinosaurs. I think that maybe they won't like me. But you don't have to worry about that, because we already know that we like you. Hi.
Hi! Sorry, I'm Tiny Pteranodon. It's great to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, Tiny. Hi. I've never seen creatures who look like you guys and who are so friendly.
Well, there's no one friendlier than Tiny.
Tiny will talk to any creature, and it doesn't matter if they're really huge or really tiny. Leslie's just the opposite. Lesotosaurus only usually hide from predators, but Leslie likes to hide from everyone.
Well, Leslie, you're the most amazing hider we've ever seen. I just like to hide a lot. That's who I am. Watch. My skin color is so much like the color of the rocks that you can't even see me, because I don't move at all. Cool, let me try.
Buddy, are you there? I can't see anything around this big orange rock.
Okay. How about this for camouflage?
Wow, is that the bush or Buddy I'm looking at?
I guess it's a T-Rex bush.
Good one, Leslie.
Yeah, I guess I'm not very good at using camouflage. Nothing like you, Leslie. But I'm good at being a T-Rex.
Rawr! Run and hide!
I wish she didn't have to leave. I'm having so much fun, and I'm not even hiding. Well, now I am. Down you two! Come on out!
Hiding is fun, but it's fun to meet new creatures, too. And there are so many to meet.
How do you do it, Tiny? How is it so easy for you to talk to other creatures and not be afraid?
I can't really say, but I can sure sing it. I'm not the biggest dinosaur, I've got some kind of tiny. I don't have teeth or scary claws, but it doesn't make me whiny. Whenever I need someone new, I march right up, and what I do
is say hello there, nice to meet you.
My name is Tiny.
I've met a lot of dinosaurs and some of them were scary. And when I stand right next to them, I'm kind of ordinary. But if I'm friendly, they are too. And when I say it's nice to meet you, then they say, well, hey, the same to you.
It's nice to meet you, Tiny.
Hello there, Pteranodon family. Hope you had a nice trip. Meet any Lesotosaurus?
We did. A really nice one named Leslie.
She's...
Hey, where'd you go?
Leslie, where are you?
Hi, I'm Leslie. And it's nice to meet you, Mr. Conductor.
The pleasure is all mine, Miss Lesotosaurus.
Wow, Leslie, you did it. You walked up and introduced yourself to someone new.
I couldn't have done it if I hadn't met you and Buddy. You really helped me. Thanks.
You're welcome. Great to meet you.
All aboard!
Buddy, Tiny, time to head home. Bye, Lesotosaurus family.
Bye! Come visit her next sometime. We'll play hide and seek.
And I bet you'll be harder to find than our dad.
Bye!
Hi there. I'm Dr. Scott, the paleontologist, and this is Lesotosaurus.
I don't see a dinosaur.
Well, this dinosaur is using camouflage.
What's camouflage?
Well, animals camouflage when it blends in with its surroundings to hide from other creatures. There, now can you see the dinosaur? We don't know for sure if Lesotosaurus had camouflage coloring, but some dinosaurs must have. Lots of animals living today use camouflage, either to hide from predators or to hide when they're hunting. Now, can you find the polar bear in this picture?
It's right here.
There's the polar bear.
Right. Now, can you find the butterfly in this picture?
I see it. There's the butterfly.
That's it. Okay, last one. Can you find the frog in this picture? It blends in really well.
I see it. It's a frog.
Good eyes. This is an Asian leapfrog. Pretty amazing camouflage, huh? Hey, where'd you guys go? Now the kids are using camouflage. Okay, keep watching for more dinosaur discoveries.
Dinosaurs have feathers. Troodons have feathers?
It's like me.
Whoa, they're amazing.
Well, thanks, buddy.
I'm a northern troodon. We're different because we got a lot more feathers, eh?
We're looking for a match for this feather.
Looks familiar.
I wish I had your amazing feathers. Can we compare this one to yours?
Wow,
the feather mystery is solved.
Woohoo! Yeah.
All aboard, let's take a ride on the dinosaur train. Here she comes, right on time, the dinosaur train's coming down the line.
All aboard, all aboard!
Rattle and dance from the land war. She's hopping and a-popping like a hurricane. Let's take a ride on the dinosaur train.
Hello, folks. It's me, the conductor. Today, we'll take a look at a Cretaceous plant that's a carnivore. That's right, a plant that eats bugs. So come on along with me on the dinosaur train.
All aboard!
Yeah! Okay, now we're playing Be a Plant, Then Stay Still. So, be a plant or a tree.
I'm a tree.
Me too.
I'm a big plant with wavy arms.
Okay, now stay still.
I'm a wavy plant, and I like to eat animals, and bugs, and pteranodons.
Ton, there's no such thing as a plant that eats those things.
There is now.
Come on, come back and be still.
Okay, you make up the rhymes.
And we'll divide the kids into teams.
What are Mom and Dad laughing about?
I don't know. Let's find out.
Oh, what?
Dad, what are you doing?
What?
We're making a plan.
That's right. For today.
Ooh, something for all of us to do?
Absolutely. It's something fun for our whole family.
Yay! But what is it?
All right, Team Pteranodon, here's the plan. First, we take the dinosaur train to...
Ankylosaurus Acres?
Stegosaurus Forest?
Troodon Town?
We're going to the big pond. Yay! And there's the dinosaur train. Yay! Let's go, team.
I really want to know what the fun plan is.
Please tell us. Pretty please with little fishies on top.
Are we going fishing? Or tracking?
Or hiding and seeking?
Well, we were going to wait till we got there, but here goes. We're doing a family scavenger hunt.
What?
A scavenger hunt is when you get clues to help you find things.
A scavenger hunt!
Hi, two, buddy.
Hi, three.
Yeah!
Oh, there's the train. Let's hurry.
Woohoo!
Yeah!
A scavenger hunt? Oh, you Pteranodon family, forever having fantastic family fun!
Yeah! Maybe we'll have to hunt for a really big fish!
Or a conifer tree!
Or a frog!
Or a plant with wavy arms that eats animals and bugs and dinosaurs!
Oh, Dawn, this is a real scavenger hunt. We're not going to hunt for a plant that's not even real.
Actually, Shiny, there is a real plant like that.
There is?
I knew it. Tell us about it, Mr. the Conductor.
Indeed I will. This is the Drosera plant. It's actually a plant that's a carnivore.
A carnivore? Like me?
That's right. The Drosera eats the bugs that land on it. They end up down its tube.
Why?
Well, all living things eat. Carnivores eat meat, herbivores eat plants, and plants need water and sunlight. But some plants, like the Drosera, need more. They need bugs.
Woohoo!
So we might find Drosera plants at the big pond?
Yep. Maybe you'll see one on this trip, or maybe another time. Oh, speaking of time, we're here! Big pond! Next stop, big pond! Good luck, Pteranodon family, and happy hunting! Scavenger hunting, that is!
Okay, Team Pteranodon, let's huddle by the puddle. Listen close. I know you can, because here's the super scavenger hunt plan. Hunt?
Rock!
There are four things all of you are going to hunt for.
Four different things?
Right. But there'll be clues that rhyme.
Cool. I love rhymes.
Oh, and one more thing. Your mom and I think it'd be fun to divide into teams.
Goody. I love teams. It'll make the scavenger hunt even more fun.
So, each team will get the same clue and search for the same item.
Okay, I'll decide the teams.
Thanks, Shiny. But Dad and I have already decided the teams. Team 1 is Tiny Dawn and me. Team 2 is Shiny Buddy and Dad.
Yay!
Rawr! Good teams, Mom.
All right, ready for your first clue? That's the rhyme about the item you'll be looking for. You solve it together as a team. Take it away, hun.
Listen carefully, kids. We found him by digging in the ground. His parts were scattered all around. A skeleton from his toes to his head. This fellow's name is...
Good luck, Buddy and Shiny and Dad!
Thanks! Good luck to you guys!
We found him by digging...
A skeleton...
Toes to his head. Is it something in Dawn's collection?
A skeleton from his toes to his...
Mom! Tiny! It's Fossil Fred!
You're right, Dawn! Hurry! Let's fly there!
Fossil Fred!
Good clue, Mom and Dad. It's amazing that this was once a living dinosaur.
Yeah, these fossils are really old bones that turn into rock.
That's our Fossil Fred. Okay, what's the next clue, Mom?
I have it. Listen carefully. A shell on his back is one of his features, and he borrowed it from some other creature. He's a friendly guy, and he likes to gab. This fellow is a...
A shell on his back. A turtle?
But he borrowed his shell. You bet it's a shell on the beach.
Come on! Let's get to the beach. Hurry! A friendly guy, and he likes to gab. This fellow is a... hermit crab!
Oh, right! Henry! His home is a shell!
Good one, Shiny. Thanks. Start looking under every shell, Buddy and Dad.
Henry!
Wait! I think I see some little feet sticking out of that one. Henry, it's me, Shiny!
Shiny? Hey! My old pals, Shiny and Buddy, and Mr. Pteranodon! What's new?
We're on a scavenger hunt, and one of the clues was about you.
Hey, I like being a clue. Glad I could be of service.
Henry, I observed that you have the same shell you had the last time we saw you.
Right. I haven't grown out of my shell yet, but pretty soon I'll have to vamoose and find another empty shell to move into.
That's what hermit crabs do. Okay, Mom and Dad, what's the next clue for the scavenger hunt?
I wish I was bigger. Then I could play the game, too.
Wait, I have an idea.
The clue. This likes to eat all kinds of bugs. I repeat, to it, bugs are a treat. It might eat a beetle. It might eat an ant. It grows in the ground. It's a... Maybe I can come along and, you know, help with the clues.
I'll carry you, Henry. Come on.
This likes to eat all kinds of bugs. I like it already, whatever it is.
It might be a beetle. It might be an ant. Hey,
plant rhymes with ant. Mom, Dawn, I bet it's the Drosera plant that the conductor told us about.
Yeah, let's look where all the flowers are.
Oh, bug-eating plant, la-la-loo, where are you?
If it eats bugs, does the plant have a tummy?
Remember the picture the conductor showed us? Kind of had a tube for a tummy.
Hey, lots of bugs flying that away.
Yes!
The Drosera plant, just like the conductor's picture.
Look, bug just landed on it. Whoa. Bug went down its tube.
Well, that's where the Drosera plant eats the bug. You see, it has sweet nectar on its inside, and that makes bugs want to land on it. Then the plant slowly eats it.
Wow, this is my new favorite plant.
Ew!
Disgusting!
Okay, next clue, please.
Great job, Team Pteranodon. You found three items on the scavenger hunt. And now, the fourth and final clue.
This dinosaur has teeth, a tail, and three-toed feet. He's really friendly, really sweet. A creature everyone likes to meet.
Lots of teeth.
And three-toed feet.
Really sweet. It's a creature everyone likes to meet. Who do we like to meet?
It sounds like some kind of theropod. I wonder if it's a carnivore.
Lots of teeth.
A creature everyone likes to meet.
I got a pretty good idea who it is.
It's Buddy!
Me?
You're right! It's Buddy!
My teammate is the answer! It's my brother, Buddy!
Buddy! We were both close!
That scavenger hunt was the best!
But who won?
Won? Well, we all won! Great job, team!
Thanks, Mom and Dad! That was fun!
We had so much fun, too! Bet all that scavenger hunting made you all hungry. How about some lunch? Fish for everybody!
Yeah, but not hermit crabs, right?
A scavenger hunt, some rhymes and lunch with a family that I love a bunch. We got four clues and figured them out.
And that's what a scavenger hunt's about. Scavenger hunt! Scavenger hunt!
Scavenger hunt!
Hi there, I'm Dr. Scott the paleontologist, and this is the Drosera plant, also called a sundew. Now most plants get all their energy from sunlight, but a few, like this one, actually get some of their energy from eating insects.
Plants that eat insects?
Yep, the insects go to the plant hoping to find food, but instead they get stuck on the hairs and are eaten by the plants. There were Drosera plants during the time of the dinosaurs, and today they're found on every continent except Antarctica. And they come in lots of different sizes, shapes, and colors.
Hungry plants?
The most famous insect-eating plant is called the Venus flytrap.
Venus flytrap!
It's just a small plant, but when an insect lands on one of its leaves, it closes, trapping the bug.
Mmm, tasty bugs.
Okay, remember, get outside, get into nature, and make your own discoveries.
Did you know that the dinosaur train travels everywhere in the Mesozoic era? Let's look at the map. There was the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous time periods. Let's visit the Jurassic. It was a warm, damp climate full of both jungles and forests. The first known birds and many of the biggest dinosaurs, like Stegosaurus, lived in the Jurassic. And that's just one of the stops on the dinosaur train.
Time for a tiny ditty.
And we figured it out.
We figured it out. We worked together and figured it out.